infrastructure sector. There are a few things in news in infrastructure. First thing we will begin with is national logistics policy. You know, so few thing in news in infrastructure. First thing we begin with is national logistics policy. So when you look at logistical sector, it's all about making the product reach from the manufacturer, a raw material, to the manufacturer, to the consumers. And the national logistic policy, the basic objective is to develop a technologically enabled and integrated, cost efficient, sustainable system. Technologically enabled, integrated, sustainable cost-effective system. That is what is the basic idea. And there are four pillars of NLP. The four pillars of national logistic policy, and just remember these pillars, again from prelims point of view, they can come in play. One is unified logistics interplay platform, ULIP, unified logistics interplay platform. And this is for a three-tier structure to bring all digital services related to logistics, you know, transportation, on a single portal. Three-tier structure to bring all transportation related sectors on a single platform to bring more coordination among them, you know, railways, roadways, waterways, airways. The idea is to bring them all together, you know, and that will mean that there will be more interplay between them, and that can be caught. And this will be unified logistics interplay platform. Ek hi jagah pe sare decision ho jaye, connectivity bani rahe, seamless transition ho from one mode to another. Agar aapko railway se roadway pe jana hai, to pehle se hi decided hona chahiye, and the platform will help in achieving that basic target. So there is unified logistic integrated platform. Then the portion in industry remaining was e-commerce, which I have already covered. Akash, I'm answering your question. ONDC is under Ministry of Commerce, but MeitY is something which is the regulatory authority on it. Bhavna, I'm answering your question. ONDC is under Ministry of Commerce, but MeitY is the regulatory institution in that. All right. Then the next thing, or the second pillar that you talk about, is integration of digital systems. That is the second pillar that we talk about. Integration of digital system. So integration of digital system mainly implies that you have systems which can integrate different departments, you know, and including data from different transport and logistic departments. So digital integration using unified logistic interface platform to connect data sharing among different service providers. So there is another thing that needs to be done. Then the third pillar of ULIP, the third pillar is e-logs, that is ease of logistics. You know, basic idea of e-logs is that they develop a digital platform for industry associations for any performance issue with the government directly, you know. Developing a digital platform to be used by industry to register any complaint or suggestion regarding logistics to the government. That is the idea of ease of logistics. And then it says that the fourth pillar will be developing a system improvement group, you know, SIG. So this will monitor all logistic projects through group of officers from all the concerned ministries. For monitoring of all logistic projects through group of secretaries and joint secretaries related to each concerned ministry. So these are the four pillars of national logistics policy based on which it will be run. And it will be run directly through empowered group of secretary. And these empowered group of secretaries will be connected to each other through PM Gati Shakti. The empowered group of secretaries will be connected to each other through PM Gati Shakti, where Gati Shakti portal will be used for real-time information about all logistic related projects. All right, this is the basic idea that we go by, that you know, when you look at ease of logistics, system improvement, digital integration, you know, integrated digital integration and unified logistic interface portal. So this is what you need to keep in mind with respect to the four, logistic related issues on ULIP and national logistics policy. The basic aim is to improve India's logistical performance and reduce logistical cost of India from 13-14% of GDP to a standard 7-8% of GDP. All right, so the main objective main target is to reduce logistical cost of India from 13-14% of GDP to 7-8% of GDP, which will make India a competitive business economy and will attract investments into India. You know, it makes India a competitive business economy and will attract investments into India. And as I said, this will be integrated to the Gati Shakti portal.